Thank you, Chakravarti sir. I thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity, and I am more thankful to the organizers for giving importance to microbes, especially GM microbes in a world where GM plants rule. Microbes have generally been neglected. In fact, a few years back, we did not have very defined SOPs also related to microbes. I will be talking on this. I am a last minute entry, and the only reason I agreed to this talk is this is a work which was done around 8 years back. Now I am working on wheat transgenics. But the reason was that microbes, GM microbes, are a very, very gold mine which needs to be exploited, and they would have direct use especially for agriculture. My work would be on engineering an environmentally friendly Azotobacter strain to improve nitrogen fixation efficiency. Again, over here, I would like to say I am basically only a presenter. The actual worker is Godandapani, and the concept, the guiding force is Dr. H.K. Das. He is retired professor from JNU, and he was INSA fellow at NRCPB, our center. So it is basically his brainchild, and unfortunately, both of them, Dr. Das due to his age and Dandapani due to his new assignment at MS Swaminathan Foundation, they could not come, so I am doing their duty. We all know that nitrogen is an important element, but unfortunately, most of the nitrogen cannot be utilized by plants because they cannot take inert gas form of nitrogen. Therefore, plants can only use combined form of nitrogen, ammonia or nitrate. So this nitrogen fixation in nature takes place by two methods. This is just brief introduction to set the ball rolling. Biological and non-biological. Somehow biological nitrogen fixation, especially in case of agriculture land, is quite dominant. And this just explains the nitrogen cycle and the relationship between three principal nitrogen pools: atmospheric, soil, and biomass. Now, when we talk of biological nitrogen fixation versus chemical nitrogen fertilizers, the biological nitrogen fixers are unable to meet the nitrogen demand of agricultural crops, especially with the advent of green revolution in India. Because of that, the input incentive cultivars, which require a lot of nitrogen fertilizers, are needed, and biological nitrogen fertilizers are not able to cope with that. Therefore, we need enhanced production of nitrogen fertilizers and their usage. So data shows that their consumption is increasing, and it would increase further, especially in the East Asia and South Asia countries. So nitrogen fertilizers, we call them a necessary evil. We cannot do without them. But they are ecologically and economically inhibitory. They consume a lot of energy. The process of making nitrogen fertilizers itself is very, very energy intensive. Then the high cost, the farmers have to pay a lot of it, and leads to a lot of environmental problems. Now, can we have biological nitrogen fixers working together with chemical nitrogen fixers? Is it possible? If we go to the biology of nitrogen fixers, we know that microbes, there are three kinds of microbes which fix nitrogen: non-symbiotic, blue-green algae, and symbiotic. Our study concentrates on Azotobacter crococcum, which is a heterotrophic non-symbiotic nitrogen fixer. Now, here is the point that nitrogen fixing system in nitrogen fixers, they do not fix nitrogen in presence of fixed nitrogen. That means if ammonia is present, they will not fix nitrogen. Then Azotobacter is anaerobic and it works at temperature below 30 degrees centigrade. The enzyme responsible is nitrogenase. So this slide explains that how the NIF-L operon is the key player in nitrogen fixing process in most of the nitrogen fixers. In the presence of chemical nitrogen fertilizers, there is no biological nitrogen fixation taking place because the ammonia generated by the chemical fertilizer switches off the NIF-LA operon. As a result, if you try to put, if you think that, okay, 50% of nitrogen fertilizer and 50% of biological fertilizers, they will not work together. And this further leads to the question, can we have nitrogen fixation process to be continuous? That means there is no switch off. Can the nitrogen fixing ability of Azotobacter be improved? Again, over here we mean, can it work in the presence of ammonia or any other fixed inorganic nitrogen? Finally, can a mixture of bacterial and chemically synthesized fertilizers be employed together to obtain good grain yield at reduced environmental cost? With this idea, Dr. H.K. Das, he tried to find answers, and there have been reports, like people have already thought about this, that if we free all the genes involved in nitrogen fixation from any negative regulation, it would lead to enhanced nitrogen fixation even in the presence of ammonium, so that biofertilizers can be used even in the presence of chemical nitrogen fertilizers. And so over here, the jugglery has to take place with NIF-L gene, which is the repressor gene, which is responsible for switching off in presence of ammonium or any fixed nitrogen. So our strategy basically involved that we did, if I just give an outline, it is deletion in NIF-L and a constitutive promoter. And this may add it so that when there is deletion in NIF-L, you have actually knocked out NIF-L, and NIF-A will continue to synthesize nitrogenase enzyme and do nitrogen fixation even in the presence of ammonia. The strategy involved was, first we isolated the gene NIF-L, and based on the sequence of NIF-L, we tried to do deletion and made a construct. Then in this, we tried to add kanamycin interposon. This would help us in tracking where our plasmid has gone. Using this, we did transformation of Azotobacter crucocum. Now, Azotobacter crucocum has 20 chromosomes. So we did, this is homologous recombination taking place. As a result, 18 to 20 subcultures are needed within a period of 8 days to see that it goes to all the chromosomes. You can see that over here, which shows a single band. This is the 18th subculture. Previous subcultures, you would see more bands. So once we are sure that it has gone to all the chromosomes, it was confirmed with Southern. Now the next step was synthetic promoter. This synthetic promoter was designed based on sigma 70 promoter, which is a constitutive promoter. The native promoter of Azotobacter crucocum is sigma 54. In this case, another construct was developed along the same lines. That is the NIF-L gene. In this, we put the synthetic promoter, again put it in E. coli, then go in for transformation of Azotobacter, and we again look for, after 18 subcultures, we get one single band, which is proved by Southern hybridization also. Now we try to see what is the growth pattern of this mutant. This is a mutant which has deletion in NIF-L. In fact, NIF-L is knocked out, and it has a synthetic promoter based on sigma 70 sequence. and we found that it was able to grow well in presence of nitrogen also. Similarly, nitrogenase activity, ARA activity was also studied, and we found that in presence of urea, 0.1% urea, in this experiment is taking place in the media, it is able to grow well. It is, nitrogenase activity is there. Next, we moved on to seed treatment. Using this microbe, which we call as mutant, we did seed treatment of wheat seeds. This microbe was actually isolated by microbiology division IRI from cotton field. But it has shown to be worked. IRI division microbiology has worked on it, and they have shown that it performs well in a number of crops, including wheat, pearl millet, sorghum. So they have standardized. So we also tried to concentrate on wheat because wheat is an important crop of India. And using this seed treatment, we tried to see that there was growth, and there was biomass studies were also done. Leaf length was also seen. And you can see that in the presence of CBD15 mutant, we call it mutant M1, and nitrogen source, this growth biomass is good. Similarly, the other parameters were done. These are very preliminary experiments which have taken place only in the pot, in a net house. And so we tried to see what all it was affecting chlorophyll content. Total leaf protein was taken, and this also we found. Then nitrate content was also studied. Then we also tried to see what is the effect on pH. And we found there was not much effect on soil pH or soil moisture. It was as the native strain. Spikes were also studied. We took it to maturity, and we found that